Well, I'm really become dead serious about breeding these bettas. And you will see that I am here in the middle of this very beautiful bettas. So our purpose today is to make an update about this business. Hi guys, it's a beautiful day once again and welcome back to Dexter's World Channel. Well, I'm really become dead serious about breeding these bettas and also selling them at a good price. Actually, I've been doing this as what I have told you for the past 20 years and it gives us good alternative way of earning an income. And you will see that I am here in the middle of this very beautiful bettas and they are now individually placed in the bottles. And we call this the jarring. We jarred them already and they are here. And maybe you're interested about how many bettas do we have right now? Well, we have completed the 800 male bettas in separate jars or containers. And I just decided to groom them before I'm gonna sell them to the market because I realized that we can sell them at a good price when they are already adults. And if you are interested to venture this business and you're also interested on how to breed this one, the link is provided below, the step-by-step process on how to breed these bettas. And those tutorials that we have made are really very effective. And many of those who have subscribed to our channel had been blessed also by the sharing that we have uploaded in our videos. So our purpose today is to make an update about this business. And you will see that we have here so many bottles and we are going to place these bottles right here beside the house. And this place is good because this is very accessible to water and this is covered. This will not be directly hit by the sunlight and we are also able to drain the water very easily. So this is the best and very ideal place for our bettas. What you're gonna witness today is for us to arrange all these bottles according to its sizes, of course, right here. And we can also use this bigger portion for another grooming of bettas. I am thinking about grooming 5,000 bettas for this year. I hope that this can be materialized because I just realized that if we can groom 1,000 bettas, and we're gonna sell them at 150 pesos each. So we will be thinking about 150,000 as an income in just a matter of 3 to 4 months or maybe 5 months with less capital. Of course, your capital is just your effort. So guys, we have just put in place 800 male betas here in the side of the house. And I am using this plastic container. Yesterday, we were so busy then buying all these bottles. And now it's done. And I'm so proud of this. And I hope I can encourage other people who are into breeding these betas. We can maximize our profit if we can groom them. And we will wait for at least 5 to 6 months before we're gonna sell them in the market. So now the next activity is to let you see how we're gonna change the water. Maybe you're in doubt about how we're gonna manage to change the water because these are already massive, there are plenty. And we are doing this on a regular basis. So come on, let's demonstrate how we're gonna fill this jars with water, and we will explain how we can maintain the condition of the water inside the bottles. Come on, let's do this, and please witness this, guys. So now we will demonstrate to you how we're gonna change this water, because the life of the betta depend upon the condition of the water. And I already have mentioned in our earlier video that if we're gonna change frequently the water inside in the bottles, we can be assured that they will grow fast and they are safety. They will not die inside. So our way of conditioning the water is, of course, to frequently change it, add some little amount of it like this one, and the water will just drain because we have made an exit hole, and the water will just overflow. In this method, we can of course maximize our time without spending too much time changing this water. I'm a busy man, a very busy person, and I have to make some innovations on how to do about these things. And you will see that the bettas are healthy. And maybe you will ask, Dexter, how often do you do this activity, changing the water? Well, I'm doing this once a week, and especially on Saturdays, because on Saturdays I have ample time, and I can still manage my time. Of course, you know that I am a government worker, and I'm also maintaining this farm, and we have the blogs, we have everything, we have this pet store, and doing all these tasks are not easy. And for you to understand better, allow me to just demonstrate how it is done. So if you will fill that with water, of course, the bettas will enjoy the new fresh water. When the water is good, the betta will also feel good. See that? You don't have to get the bettas out of the bottle and then change the water. You just pour water on it, and then the water will spill over and the water will become fresh. And now we're gonna demonstrate how we're gonna feed all these bettas. Well, you know that these bettas can grow very fast if you have actually the live food, which is dapnia. And we have demonstrated how we're gonna catch these dapnias in our previous videos. And I'll invite you to please also view that. We went to the stagnant waters where we collect these dapnias, gather some of these dapnias to feed our bettas. And you were asking about, teach us how we're gonna find this one. Well, these crustaceans are just available in swampy waters, in rice fields. And maybe you will now become very observant and start looking at the swampy areas if you can find dapnias. And that's very helpful for the success of our betta farm. And maybe you will say that, Dexter, I have dapnias, but it is not enough for my fish. Well, I recommend some food. Actually, here I have this betta fry feed. Well, these products are good, and I use this food for the fry. And we have these granules right here. You can also use this for the goldfish and other similar fish like the bettas, the discos. You can use this one, and also this granules, this pelletized feeds, and they are very effective, especially for the fry of our fish. The goldfish, betas, danius, and even mollies and the guppies. So guys, we will start now feeding our betas, of course, with the assistance of our staff. He will begin right there, and I also begin right here. And you will see that we will use this empty bottle of the soft drinks, and we put some water and live food there inside. You will see that. And of course, we can maximize our time if we're gonna use this one. So you will see how this is done. Of course, just like that. Okay. This is it. In less than 5 minutes, we were able to feed all these 800 betas in their individual containers. And this makes our effort easy and maximize our time. And in this life, of course, we can just adopt some techniques on how to make life easy. And these techniques will eventually lead us to our success. And you will see also that the betas there inside in the bottles are really in their A1 condition, because you will see that some of them are already making bubbles, just like this one. Oh, you see that? This is a good indication that the health of the beta is really perfect. When this beta starts making bubbles, meaning that they are already approaching on their adulthood. And if you will look at my tutorials on how to breed betas from tutorial 1 to 6 or 7, I think, I explained to you the importance of choosing our breeders. And one of which that I have mentioned is the breeder that can make plenty of bubbles, because that is likely to become a good breeder. That male beta that can produce plenty of bubbles, this is likely to be a good father of your breeding of your betas. And I have explained that. And of course, right at the side, we are already grooming female betas. I will let you see. And this will become our spawners. When you are going to choose female betas to become your spawner, of course, you will pamper it. You will put that in a big container and you will feed them with good food so that the eggs will develop inside in their belly. And at around 5 to 6 months, they are already ready for breeding. And many of you have asked, Dexter, why is it that my male beta is killing the female beta, or the other way around? The female beta is killing the male beta. Well, my answer is simple. Your breeders are not yet ready to breed. And maybe you did not pass the acquaintance stage, which I mentioned in our earlier videos. And this acquaintance stage is actually putting the male beta or the female beta in a clear glass and then allowing them to see each other without, of course, reaching each other. And this is the method that we have adopted, and this is very effective. The acquaintance stage. You cannot just buy one beta here, female beta, and another beta, male beta, and then you will put that immediately in the breeding tank. They will really kill each other, because they have the tendency to fight. So these are the things that we are doing here, and I hope that this will encourage you. And those of you who are also beta lovers, you can also make some suggestions. I know that many of us are expert on this field, and you can also contribute something by making comments and share your experiences, success stories, and how you do about your beta breeding. This can be really admirable, and I really appreciate that, educating our followers, some of our followers and our viewers. So these are the things that we can share with you so far. I hope you will continue to like and share our videos. And if you are not subscribed to this channel, may we humbly ask you to please subscribe and hit that notification bell, because we are uploading videos regularly. And if you will subscribe, you will be notified of our regular uploads only here at Dexter's World!